This is a quick puzzle to test how good you are at problem solving. There are four cards in front of you. Each card has a letter on one side and a number on the other. You need to turn over the cards to prove the following rule is true. If a card has an A on one side, then it has a 2 on the other side. Which cards should you turn over to test the rule? Many people would select the A card and the 2 card. However, turning over the 2 is unnecessary because the rule doesn't say that all cards with 2 must have the letter A on the other side. It only states that if there's an A, it must have a 2 on the reverse. But what about the 3 card? Flipping over the 3 card is essential because if it has an A on the other side, it would violate the rule. This step is often overlooked because our minds are inclined to seek confirmation rather than disconfirmation when testing a rule. When you see the A card, you might instinctively want to check it to confirm the rule to see if there's a 2 on the other side, whereas flipping over the 3 card doesn't immediately confirm the rule. It only has the potential to disprove it. In 1963, British cognitive psychologist Peter Wason ran this experiment at the Harvard Center for Cognitive Studies, and only about 10% of participants solved the puzzle. The prevailing belief at the time in cognitive psychology was that humans are inherently rational beings. Wason's work shattered that assumption, revealing how people often fail to reason logically, even in seemingly simple situations. One of his students who wrote an obituary about him noted that he believed psychologists should never know quite why they were doing an experiment. He preferred to let the results speak for themselves. But what happens when you move from abstract puzzles to real-life situations? Imagine you're at a bar, and each card in front of you represents a person at the bar. The cards you see are a person drinking beer, a person drinking soda, a person who is 22 years old, a person who is 19 years old. Let's say the legal drinking age is 21. Your task is to ensure the bar is serving drinks in accordance with the law. Which cards should you flip over to verify this? Many people instinctively select the card showing the person drinking beer to check if they are of legal drinking age, which is correct. But what about the other cards? Flipping over the card of the person drinking soda doesn't help because there's no law about what age you have to be to drink soda. Similarly, you don't need to check the 22-year-old's drink because they are of legal drinking age, regardless of what they're drinking. However, you should flip over the card showing the person who is 19 years old. If that card reveals an alcoholic drink on the other side, then the bar is breaking the law. This scenario is much easier for people to understand. In fact, when the problem is presented in this more familiar context, researchers found the success rate jumps from 10% to 75%. Wason hinted at the possibility of dual processes in reasoning, which was later popularized by psychologist Daniel Kahneman in his book, Thinking, Fast and Slow. Kahneman describes two systems we use when we think. System one is fast and intuitive, like when you drive a familiar route, read words on a large billboard, or finish the phrase bread and. System two is slower and more deliberate, like when you brace for the starting pistol in a race, solve a complex math problem, or park in a tight spot. In the abstract card puzzle, people often engage system one, responding quickly yet incorrectly because the problem is unfamiliar. In the real-life bar scenario, system one still engages, but because the system is familiar, it leads to correct answers. So, how can we overcome these errors in abstract reasoning? By inhibiting our natural, often automatic responses in favor of more deliberate and logical thinking, which engages system two. In the 1990s, Cornell psychologists David Dunning and Justin Kruger made a surprising discovery. When they gave a brief training session to undergraduate students who struggled with a Wason selection task, not only did their logical reasoning skills improve, but they also became more self-aware, so that they became better at spotting and correcting their own mistakes. Now that you're more familiar with logic puzzles, let's see how well you do with another challenge. Each of the four cards has a shape on one side and a solid color on the other. The sides you see are a red triangle, a solid blue, a purple square, and a yellow hexagon. The rule is, if a card has a red triangle on one side, then it has a solid blue color on the other side. Which cards do you flip? You'd flip the red triangle card to check if the other side is blue or not, and that's all. There's no need to flip the solid blue card because the rule doesn't mention anything about what should be on the other side of a blue card. This task is tricky because it plays on the assumption that you need to do more to test the rule, when in fact, the correct and logical approach is more straightforward. While the Wason selection task is a test of logical reasoning, it also reveals something deeper about how our minds work. Our brains are wired to seek out confirmation of what we believe to be true. We have a tendency to focus on information that supports our existing beliefs while ignoring anything that contradicts them. But this can lead you down a risky path. Imagine you invest in a tech stock because you believe in the company's future. You start seeking out news, reports, and expert opinions that confirm your belief that the stock will perform well, and you might ignore or downplay any negative news or analysis about the company. The story of BlackBerry is an example of how confirmation bias ruined a company. If you're excited about buying a new product, you might only read positive reviews, overlooking the negatives, which might lead to buyer's remorse later on. By being aware of these tendencies, we can make more informed and balanced decisions that engage System 2 thinking and challenge our own assumptions. Research shows that studying higher mathematics can sharpen your logical thinking. If you want to build on that, Brilliant is the perfect platform. I've just started on their Predicting with Probability course, which applies mathematical reasoning to make informed decisions, like being able to predict which airline is least likely to have a delay due to weather. Or you can master Bayes' rule, a powerful tool for refining your thinking and updating your beliefs by combining what you know with new evidence. In today's world, these critical thinking skills are absolutely essential. You can try out Brilliant for free for 30 days by signing up at brilliant.org/newsthink. That's brilliant.org/newsthink for a free trial, link in the description, or scan my QR code on your screen. You'll also receive 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription, giving you access to thousands of lessons. Thanks for watching. For Newsthink, I'm Cindy Pom.